The first question, I would like to ask you that question back to you, because you know, I don't feel qualified to comment on the effect of conflict. But just to make two observations, one is, it is striking that in spite of the awful tragedy of the ongoing conflict in Arm and you know, elsewhere, it hasn't really had a national impact. I mean, in a sense, if you look at the rosy, you know, macro story for the last 6 years, it's sort of been delinked from the terrible conflict, you know, in your part of the world. And I suppose that tells me that somehow your part of the world, you know, in terms of national sort of importance is very small, but terrible though it is. One other thing just strikes me thinking comparatively, in spite of the conflict, the persistent conflict, Philippines is a really low spending country when it comes to defense. I mean, the worry in some conflict countries, you think of a country like Pakistan, where the conflict has led to a huge military budget, which is in a sense crowded out all the other things you want governments to spend on. So the Philippines is a very low spending country on defense, which I guess is a positive by and large. One other point just to mention, for the other rest of the audience, you were too modest to mention it. This very interesting paper by you and some colleagues, including at ANU, on the three major bypass regions of Southeast Asia, at least excluding Burma, Myanmar, and that is Papua in Indonesia, the three southern Thailand states in Thailand, and Arm in the Philippines, which of course you were the lead author on. The striking feature of these comparison in that paper, people may not be aware of it, very important paper, is although these problems are serious in Papua and southern Thailand, they seem to be more serious in Arm relative to the neighbours. So in a sense, that's indicative of, I guess, the nature of the challenge.